Hey everybody, it's Cam here with my reaction video for episode 7 of the first season of the live adaptation of One Piece on Netflix. You know what? Some people probably believed I wasn't going to get this one ready right after I got the other one ready, but two episodes in one day. I had the day off of work today, so I'm just going to try to bust out the rest of these and make sure I get them all taken care of and have those videos ready for everybody. All right, so obviously this is the episode where we finally get to see Nami's backstory. This episode is all about Nami, 90% of it is at least. So let's talk about the other things real quick first, and then we'll spend the rest of the time talking about her and everything we learned about her. First off, I love Buggy.
How do we know you're not leading us to a trap?
Zoro, buddy! Otterman's pirates, right? Come on, I could sing a nice sea shanty to pass the time. Oh, there once was a girl with tangerine hair. Stole my map and let me strand it somewhere. Truly a crafty and crooked young lass, but you can't deny she had a spectacular... Ow! God, right on my nose!
He's just ridiculous. I don't care if people say that he's just misunderstood. He's not really insane. He seems a little bit insane to me, but I like how he's kind of an asshole, and the crew just has to carry his head around because he is going to tell them where to find Nami and Arlong. And Buggy, he's a great part of the show just in general. Big fan of him. We do get to spend a little bit more time with Garp as well. I forgot to mention him in the last episode that we did see him just a little bit with Mihawk. And, you know, he gets real upset, smashes the room up when Mihawk tells him that he let him go because he wants to see just what Luffy can do. He thought he seemed special. But otherwise, we don't spend a lot of time with, you know, Garp in the last episode. This one, even though there's not a ton of screen time, I feel like he's a lot more important to the episode and you know, learning a little bit more about him and... I really liked his interactions with Zeff when they have dinner and they tell stories, and I just kind of enjoyed that part of it. And obviously Zeff the whole time is basically just like he did with Sanji, is trying to tell Garp that he needs to let Luffy go do his thing and pass things off to the next generation. I really liked the interaction with Bad Haircut Guy and Kobe. One of these days, maybe I'll look up his name, but I just like Bad Haircut Guy for the name more. I liked their interaction. He wasn't a jerk to him. He kind of seems like he's coming around and he's not going to be such an awful person anymore, that maybe now that he's away from his dad and he can, you know, be on his own as well. I liked their interaction, and I laughed out loud when Kobe tells him that Luffy is Garp's grandson, and he says, of all the things that you were going to tell me, that is not one of them. I absolutely laughed out loud for that part of it. Thought that was great, and I hope... I've seen some stuff, too, like, as far as, like, you know, every time I'm looking up pictures or video clips that I want to put on the episodes, that it looks like Bad Haircut Guy sticks around for some of the other stuff. So I like that he's, you know, starting to become a little bit better of a character now. Otherwise, the crew, I liked how Luffy, he shows who he is, that he's loyal and that he's always going to be there for his crew, and that he's going to go after Nami anyways, and that he never for a second doubts that there isn't a reason that she betrayed them and that he's going to go help her. Sanji seems to be on her side as well, but his is a little bit of a misogynistic of like women just don't know what they want kind of thing. Still like Sanji, but I didn't love his reasoning for being supportive of Luffy and Nami. Zoro, obviously, you know, he's the cool guy, and he thinks that, you know, she made her decision, whatever the reason was, but he's going to go along with Luffy as his captain. Usopp has just, you know, a short period where he looks scared, but otherwise he's just part of the crew. I am interested to see what he does with those smoke bombs that he has made at the end of this episode while he's talking with Buggy. As far as, let's get into then, obviously, like most of this episode just needs to be about Nami. We get to see Nami as a child. We see that a woman who was a Marine finds her and her adopted sister and on a battlefield, adopts her, and then raises her in Cocoa Village. And then we see that when they're only like 8 years old, roughly, or when Nami's like eight, I think that her sister's a little bit older, but that Arlong invades Coco Village and captures it. You know, I've told you guys last episode that I've already watched these, but I didn't catch the first time around for some reason that Arlong Park, his base, is on the same island as Coco Village. I guess I don't know why I didn't realize that the first time around, but it was something I noticed this time that, they have to pay protection money all the time. We see that Arlong kills Nami's adopted mother right off the bat, and then she goes and works for him. And so for years now, the entire village has hated her because they couldn't understand why she would go and work for the person that, you know, killed her mother and basically almost enslaved her village.
Is that any way to treat a guest?
Take it. That's all I got.
No.
Nami, Michiko, I love you girls.
And so we get to see that, though, that, she made a deal with him that if she could get 100 million berry, which is their version of dollars, that he would, you know, free the village. Obviously, he backstabs her, has a little rat marine captain take the money from her. You know, it makes sense as to everything that she's done for this entire time. She was just trying to free her village. Arlong, he makes a lot of sense too. We get to learn, kind of like he's got what he feels is righteous anger. We find out that the fishmen had been enslaved by the humans previously, that they're supposedly free now and supposed to be equal, you know, that the world government has decreed it, but that, they're mostly still treated as second-class citizens, and he wants to take over the world for the fishmen. And so, you know, he's not just a pirate because he wants to be, the most famous. He wants to take over the world for the fishmen. So that makes sense as to where, you know, like his level of anger is. All in all, I just felt like this was another really, really good episode, just like the last one was. Buggy was the comic relief, but otherwise it was a pretty serious episode, as it should be. One thing I do want to mention, Arlong Park is super cool. I think that one of the best parts about this whole first season of the series has been that it has just some great visuals. The first time that they go to Baratier and the interior of Baratier, it's just beautiful, right? I thought that the village was cool that Luffy lives in the beginning, but I just really thought that all of Arlong Park was pretty awesome. And I just kind of like everything about this series, just the way they decided to do the visuals. I also think that the season has taken a turn where I love the first couple of episodes. They were silly and lighthearted. Then I didn't like another episode or two where I thought Luffy was ridiculous and, it was starting to get darker and a little bit more serious. But these last couple, three episodes have really pulled things back to where I feel like the show has the proper gravity for what is happening around it. And Luffy, I think, is growing into being like a real captain now. They're talking about how he needs to have the responsibility. And this is the episode where you really see it. Like right here, this clip that'll be shown right now where, he says he's the captain. That perfectly encompasses who Luffy is and why he's always really going to be there for his crew. I thought the ending scene was really awesome too. They're gonna help Nami out, right? She is their crew, no matter what's happened, and as long as Luffy's in charge, you know, they're gonna stick together. All in all, I think that, you know, learning like who Nami is, finally, I always knew from the very first episode that, you know, there had to be a reason why she was gonna betray them, and I don't think that that it was any secret from the very first episode that she was obviously going to betray the crew at some point. Every single episode at the end, there was always that little, hey, Luffy, we're a crew, and her kind of, you know, having that look where you could see that she there was something going on, and I wasn't surprised in the least bit when she betrays them and ends up being part of Arlong's crew. Nami, she's clearly had a tough go of things, and hopefully from here on out, you know, the crew is going to be unified. Obviously, there's only one more episode of the season. It's clearly going to be a big fight between Luffy and Arlong. Also, you could see that Admiral Garp and his ship and his Marines, they're headed towards Coco Island as well. There's obviously going to have to be the coming together between Garp and Luffy finally, as well as in the end, there's going to have to be that fight between Arlong and the Straw Hat crew. Really excited to see where it goes, and you know what? It's just been a fun season, and I feel like it's gotten stronger and stronger the last couple episodes. All right, thanks everyone. Hope you have a wonderful day, and we'll get that last episode out here soon. Thanks.